safety mask, and everyone please remain seated, keeping those hands, arms, and legs inside the boat at all times. My parents, please watch your youngest friend for any unexpected turns. Now, my friends, I know it looks like Monstro the Whale is whaley hungry, but do not worry. He's only going to take us to a magical place called Storybook Land. Now, my friends, these are the same jaws that stole Geppetto, Pinocchio, all those years ago. But do not worry, as much Geppetto, Pinocchio, I know how to safely sail through a whale. And a fun fact for you, it is International Whale Day, so happy Whale Day, my friends. And welcome to Storybook Land. As our story started as a once upon a time, this first story we're going to talk about starts with the big bad wolf whose cave is on our left-hand side. He's always huffing and puffing, trying to blow these three little houses down on our right-hand side there. They have the three little piggies' homes. One's made of straw, one's made of stick, and one's made of 100% wolf-proof brick. Now, my friends, just around the riverbed, coming up on our left-hand side, is going to be a quaint English village. Now, this is home to Alice, where one golden afternoon, she followed a white rabbit down that rabbit hole, going down, 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 into Wonderland, where things just got curiouser and curiouser from there. Now, my friends, if that's not your cup of tea, on my right, I have London Park. Now, this is where Peter Pan took John, Michael, and Wendy Darling on their first flight to Neverland, so they never, ever had to grow up. And if you look straight ahead, my friends, you are going to see Agrabah. Now, this is where a princess named Jasmine jumped up and over those walls to see what life was really like on the other side. And when things took a turn for the worst, there was a street rat named Aladdin to come around the corner and save the day. With the power of love and a little bit of help from our friend the genie, they got married in the Sultan's Palace and they live there to this day. Now, my friends, if you're wondering why these dazzling golden arches look so familiar, that's because they are the same ones that Aladdin and Jasmine soared over, sideways, and under on their magic road ride to a whole new world. Now, my friends, if you look straight ahead, you're going to see the Cave of Wonders. Now, this is home to many, many treasure, and with treasure comes a curse. But don't worry, my friends, you're going to see a golden lamp. Legend about this lamp is there is a genie inside, and if we set him free, he'll grant us three wishes. Let's make a wish inside and see if it comes true. A little reminder, my friends. Only touch the golden lamp. Now, my friends, coming up on our right-hand side is a forest cottage. Now, the seven dwarfs live here, and one day they came across Snow White. And due to her kindness, they let her stay there to escape the evil queen. And on our left-hand side is a blue roof chateau. Cinderella lives here with her evil stepmother and her two evil stepsisters. They never ever let her do anything, my friends, not even go to the ball. But don't worry, she got a fairy godmother to grant her just that wish. Now when Cinderella did not leave by midnight, her carriage turned right back into a pumpkin. It's still there on that bridge to this day. But don't worry, my friends, Prince Charming came looking for her the very next day, and they live happily ever after in his pink castle atop the hill. Now, my friends, coming up on our left-hand side is going to be a quilted bed of succulents. Now, this is inspired by the 1933 Silly Symphony Lullaby Land. This inspired master storyteller Walt Disney. And a little fun fact for you, all of our plants here at Storybook Land are in fact real. They're kept home miniature by Tinkerbell and her pixie dust. She comes at night, sprinkles her dust all throughout the land to keep things magical and miniature for our enjoyment. And another fun fact is that all of our plants go with the story's country of origin. So on our right, all of our plants here for Alice is from England. And when we get to Geppetto's village, all of those plants are going to be from Italy because their stories are based in Italy and in London. Now, my friends, on our left is going to be a cute little home attached to this hill. Now, this is home to Mr. Toad. But unfortunately, my friends, I don't see Mr. Toad's car. He must be on a wild ride to nowhere in particular. And if you look straight ahead, you'll see Arendelle. And if you look a little closer, you're going to see Elsa's frozen castle that she built one cold, cold day. So Anna couldn't just let her sister go. She had a kingdom to run. She went, got her, brought her home so she could once again out. Do you want to build a snowman? And if you look straight ahead, you're going to see a small alpine village. Now, this is home to Geppetto, Pinocchio. When Geppetto was carving Pinocchio, he wished on his stars for him to turn into a real boy, and the blue fairy did, in fact, grant him that wish. And overlooked in this cute little home is a big summer blowout. Now, my friends, coming up on our right is our last castle, the Rhine. Now, this is home to Prince Eric, where one day a little mermaid made her first unsteady steps on the dry land of becoming part of our world. And on our left, just underneath this cave, is where Princess Ariel came from. Now, my friends, unfortunately, our time here at Storybook Land has come to an end, but do not worry, I'm going to help you.
Get the exact same theme park tickets for less, no catch, at Undercover Tourist.com.